Lourdes Central School, gearing up our education apostolate through moral and spiritual values, and making it life-enhancing specially for the poor and marginalized.
LCS is a brainchild and a dream come true of its founder, late Reverend Bernard de Souza. Today, 4th February, is dedicated as Founders Day at LCS.
Good morning to everyone gathered here. To celebrate the Founders Day, we have with us manager of our school, Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana, Principal, Reverend Father Robert de Souza, and Vice Principal, Mrs. Belita Mascarenhas. Let's put our hands together for the dignitaries of this function.
Prayer is a day without blessing, and a life without prayer is a life without power. So let us say the universal prayer. Kindly take a prayerful posture, join your hands, and join in the prayer led by the school choir.
Your bats down, please.
Lord in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Celebrate this day.
choir group for invoking God's blessings. Small cheer and great welcome makes a merry feast. It is my utmost privilege to welcome the manager of our school, Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana, a man packed with dedication. A hearty welcome to you, Father Manager. I would like to welcome our principal, Reverend Father Robert De Souza, who is the heart and soul of this institution. A cordial welcome to you, Father Principal. A wholehearted welcome to our very energetic Vice Principal, Mrs. Belita Mascarenhas. A warm welcome to you, ma'am. I would also like to welcome all the parents, teaching and non-teaching staff. We have a good number of parents who are present here. We are happy to welcome you. Among the audience, we have a special bunch of students who are present here in the school today after a long period of time. And hence, today is a much awaited day, which all of us have been waiting for a long time. That is to welcome class 6 to 8 and begin our classes. Both students and teachers are happy to see each other and will start interacting personally with one another. So here is a genial welcome to our beloved Luddites of class 6 to 8. Let's welcome them with a huge round of applause. Here is the school choir to welcome them with a beautiful song.
Welcome song. Today is undoubtedly a notable day for LCS. Here is Megan De Souza to throw light on this propitious occasion.
A very good morning to the dignitaries and all present here. Today, the 4th of February, is a red letter day marked in the calendar of Lourdes Central School. It is the day when we fondly remember and pay homage to late Reverend Father Bernard L. De Souza, the founder of Lourdes Central School. Ralph Waldo Emerson says, and I quote, "The purpose of life is not to be happy. It is to be useful, to be honorable, to be compassionate, to have it make some difference that you have lived and lived well." Reverend Father Bernard L. De Souza, the founder of LCS, was truly the man of his words, a great visionary and an educationist whose philosophy was, work is worship. He had tremendous faith in God, and he combined work with faith. He is that great man whose conviction and pure passion for providing quality education has etched his mark in the minds of many students. He not only established Lutz Central School, but many such educational institutions. He was an embodiment of wisdom, vision, and dedication. He believed that nothing is impossible. He was a trendsetter. He set trends and brought them to perfection. His motive was to provide value-based education and prepare our students to be upright citizens, honest and able administrators, and non-corrupt statesmen of tomorrow. Noble intentions received the blessings of the divine, and the founder's dream of seeing Lutz Central School grow and nurture students to be able citizens has manifested and will continue in greater measures, with our students and alumni carving their niche in different fields and profession. Today, as we pay tribute to the founder of LCS, late Reverend Father Bernard L. D'Souza, let us learn something from the life he led. Let us remember that time is not measured by the years that you live, but by the deeds that you do and the joy that you give. And each day as it comes, brings a chance to each one to excel, leaving nothing undone. Let us keep reminding ourselves that we are sent to this world to do good, and let our actions and words bring joy to others and the Lord. Thank you.
Forever in our thoughts, gone but never forgotten, our memories build bridges to you. I would like to call upon the dignitaries on the dais to honor our founder with a floral tribute.
Tribute. Reverend Father Bernard D'Souza, our founder, was a great personality who created the highest and grandest vision possible for others, because he was a strong leader who had the confidence to stand alone, the courage to make tough decisions, and compassion to listen to the needs of others. Here is Ms. Saira Pinto to recall the memories of our founder.
A very good morning to all gathered here. The journey of a thousand miles begins with one step, said Lowe's. This is apt for this day, wherein our founder stepped in his first step of the majestic ladder called Lutz Central School. And I, being one of the pioneer staff, feel honored to speak about the golden memories of our founder, late Reverend Father Bernard L. D'Souza. As I remember, at times when he was free from his work, Father Bernard would sit with us and have a friendly conversation, some of which I would like to narrate to you. He was the second child of the 10 siblings born on 11th March 1936 to late Basil D'Souza and Emishiana Mary D'Souza of Agrar, Bantwal Taluk. Father Bernard's parents must have truly blessed, as four of their children had joined the religious order, dedicating their lives to God. Three sons, including Father Bernard, became priests, and a daughter, a nun. His early education up to class 5 was at Sornad Primary School, and thereafter he joined Agrar School to complete his higher primary studies, and later he joined the seminary. Father Bernard completed his graduation and post-graduation from Karnataka University, Dharwad. He got his BA from University of Mysore. He was ordained a priest on 2nd December 1962 for Mangalore Diocese. After his ordination, Father Bernard had rendered his services at Barpur and Shirwa Church. He was a principal correspondent of St. Joseph Junior College, Bajpay, from 1972 to 1979. Later, he founded the Bombay College of High Kala at Kinigoli in the year 1981, which was truly an important landmark in the history of Mangalore. He transferred to Bijay Parish in the year 1995, where he started working on his dream project of CBSE school, and thus was born Lourdes Central School in the year 1999 with a record number of 231 students, for which he worked day and night tirelessly acquiring the funds needed. As I remember, during the construction work, Father himself worked hand in hand with the laborers, helping them and being one among them. The minute we used to hear the sound of his SD bike, which Father Bernard rode majestically, and the entire school used to be on their toes, stand still, waiting for his command. He was known for his punctuality. For example, during our school functions, if any one of the invited guests were late, Father used to tell us to begin the program and not waste time, because for him, children were more important and he did not want to keep them waiting. He was fondly called as grandfather by the little children of KG. He was disciplined, hardworking and committed. I can proudly say that the values of discipline, punctuality, hard work, dedication, teamwork, respect and humility are imbibed in the roots of every Luddite and carried forward by every member. Father Bernard was a good and able administrator and was able to achieve maximum fruits from the minimum resources at his disposal. He always fought for justice. He provided the best facilities and infrastructure for the institution wherever he served. His main purpose in life was to help the downtrodden and the less fortunate. He was very outgoing, outspoken, and friendly by nature. Being a strict disciplinarian, he motivated the students to work hard so that one day they would be recruited in the field of administrator of India, which was his dream. He believed in three T's: keep trying, stay truthful, and trust in yourself. Jackson Brown Jr. said, and I quote, "The best preparation for tomorrow is doing your best today." So did our founder, late Reverend Father Bernard L. D'Souza. The seed which was sown by him has grown into a reputed school, and we are reaping the fruit of it. And I'm sure he's watching us and praying for every Luddite from the Lord's kingdom. Let us try to walk in the footsteps of our founder and help Lourdes Central School to reach to its glory and make our founder proud. Thank you.
Pitro, for the refreshing memories. Leaders are made, they are not born. They are made by hard effort, which is the price which all of us must pay to achieve any goal that is worthwhile. Here is our principal, Reverend Father Robert D'Souza, to speak a few words on this day.
Good morning, students.
Good morning, Father.
I was desperate to hear your voice, isn't it? Without listening to you, that good morning, for the last 10 months, something great I have lost. I would like to get back. Come on. Good morning, students.
Good morning, Father.
Okay, wonderful, wonderful. Okay. Respected Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana, the manager, Vice Principal Madam Ms. Belika Mascarenhas, dear parents, staff, and my dear beloved students, a warm welcome back to all the students. You know, we have started already class 9 to 12 and it is going on successfully. And today we are privileged to get back our little students of class 6 to 8. On behalf of the management, staff, both teaching and non-teaching, I accord a cordial welcome back to all my dear class 6 to 8 students. Welcome back, dear children. Today we are also privileged to celebrate the Founders' Day. Megan and Miss Saira spoke about our founder, late Reverend Father Bernard L. D'Souza, a great visionary, a great educationist. More than that, he was a strict disciplinarian. What we can learn from him. So many points they presented before us. Let's inculcate some good practices of our founder so that we can make our founder, late Reverend Father Bernard D'Souza, proud. Definitely, he'll be very happy to see our little Luddites back to the school today. We pay homage to him. We inculcate his values and make our own and live as a proud Luddite in the society. Thirdly, we have new manager to our school. On 30th of July, he took charge of church and the school, and newness is appeared in our school. Lot of new things, lot of development, changes you can see. And on behalf of all of you, my dear Luddites, I extend a warm welcome to Lud Central School to our new manager, Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana. Welcome, Father. We already given the welcome to him, but our class 6, 7, 8, they meet him for the first time. Some of them already, maybe. That's what. Father J.B. Saldana is also an educationist, intellectual. He has many plans and projects for Lud Central School. And we, the staff and students, always extend our full support to our manager, and definitely we can see higher heights of Lud Central School very soon. On behalf of the management, staff and students, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to all our dear parents. We have 2,016 students enrolled today. That means almost 4,000 parents, dads and moms. For the last 10 months, you have struggled, no doubt. You stood with us. You stood for your children, your wards. And that is what made us to be successful today and to be confident to get our students back to the schools. No doubt, you have given your time, your energy, even your health in order to learn our students online. Thank you, my dear parents. May I ask all the students to give a loud applause. Thank you, dear parents, for all the things, all the work, all the good things you have done to continue the learning, teaching, learning process. Not in the school, but at home. Thank you very much. May God bless you. I'll say, your efforts will not go waste. Thank you for bringing your wards back to the school today. I also thank all my dear staff members, both teaching and non-teaching, all the students, well-wishers of Lud Central School, management committee members, for all the help, all the work, all the troubles they have taken during lockdown period from March 13, March 14, somewhat from that to till date. So many ideas, so much of discussion, so many meetings, virtual as well as online and offline, and so many plans. I know these efforts, this work what we have done will yield fruit. Thanking God Almighty and seeking the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes and asking the blessings of our founder, I appreciate and thank all of you. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Principal, for your motivational words and acknowledging the hard work and efforts of each one of us. To be a good manager of people requires both fairness and boldness. I now request our very affectionate manager, Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana, to share his insight on this occasion.
Respected Reverend Father Principal, the Vice Principal, the faculty members, parents and students, good morning to all of you. Good morning, children.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning, children.
Good morning, Father.
Okay, I'm happy in particular to listen to the voice of the 8th grade. They were really not coming up to the mark, but I'm happy that you are responding. First of all, we are fondly remembering our founder, late Reverend Father Bernard L. De Souza. He was not only a visionary, he truly cared for every student, every child that entered the school, wherever he was teaching. May the Lord grant him eternal rest. It is my prayer for him on your behalf. Dear parents, it's a very happy moment for all of us to see your children returning to the school. Your parents did a great job, a commendable job in handling the needs of the children. It is not an easy task, but you always supported your children. And likewise, our teaching faculty members did an exceptionally great job, first of all, learning for themselves the techniques of imparting online education and really trying to get connected with the children and giving them a quality education. I do not think any school in the vicinity has risen to this height of quality education during these months of pandemic times. The students give a huge round of applause both to the teachers and parents. Come on. Come on. Teachers, thank you very much. Parents, thank you very much. God bless you. And Reverend Father Robert De Souza has given real motivation and guidance and direction both to the teachers as well as to your students during the last months. And Father, I truly remain grateful to you. Give him a round of applause, please. With your arrival, dear students, I think 60% of the students have returned to the school. Practically 1,250 students with the 8th, 7th and 6th grades we have now in the school. Students, we have returned to the school, but these are not the normal circumstances. This is what we have to keep in mind. The times are still difficult ones, and your parents have placed a lot of trust in the management. And we are committed, and we promise to your parents that we will give not only quality education, but we will show everything that is possible in terms of keeping you safe in this context of COVID-19 pandemic. I know you have a lot of things to share with your companions and friends. Perhaps you have been suffocating for months altogether, but follow all the COVID restrictions and be always attentive to your teachers, whatever they are saying. Though it is a huge number, 1,200 plus children, We have very good system here. We will be maintaining social distance in the class. We'll be maintaining social distance even on the ground. We'll be maintaining social distance even when the recess bell goes. You know, you need to use sanitizers. You may bring your own sanitizers, or you need to wash your hands. Perhaps bring a small soap or your own towel. These are very, very essential, especially when you have breaks or when you go to the restroom. It's very important that you keep your hands clean. Never to use your hands to clean your eyes and nose without washing. That's something very, very important. Don't touch the bag or anything like books or pencil or pen of your friends. Even if something falls down, make sure that your friend picks his or her pencil or pen or book or bag, but never touch anything that belongs to somebody other than you. Likewise, it's very important that you directly go home once the school ends in the morning. Definitely your parents take extra care, but some of the parents may not be available to bring you back home. So make sure that you don't loiter here and there, and make sure that you don't touch anything here and there on the road. And even on the roads as you return home, it's very important that you keep the social distance. So wearing the mask, maintaining the social distance, and keeping ourselves very clean is very, very important. Parents, I have a small request to you. Maybe you used to wash the clothes of your children, especially the uniform, once in 2 days or once in 3 days. Students, you yourself make a special effort to wash your uniform. Don't wait for your parents to come home in the evening. So once you return home, soak it in surf or some soap and wash it. Hang it out there, dry it well, and wear every day fresh uniform, clean uniform, because you do not know who is asymptomatic or where you are getting some saliva as you're walking by the way. You never know. That is why keeping your uniform, including your shoes, your belt, your socks, your badges, everything very clean, spick and span, is a must. That you need to keep in mind. The Lourdes School is not just worried about your bookish education. No, we are interested about your integral growth. Integral growth means that you need to be self-disciplined students. You should be respecting everybody, no matter what caste or creed they belong. It is immaterial. The teachers also have been instructed in like manner, that they respect all of you in an equal manner, with respect. And children learn to respect everybody. It would be an ayah, a scavenger, it could be a principal, it could be a teacher, it could be a companion. Respecting everybody is very, very important, because it is a part of the integral growth of every child that comes into the school, because we want to form great citizens of a great nation, India. You know, we remember today late Reverend Father Bernard. It is because of his past, it is because of his yesterday, we have a beautiful today and we'll have a brighter tomorrow. Great people who have sacrificed for the well-being of education, for nation building, are remembered every now and then. And someday we will be remembering you as great people who have contributed to your families, who have contributed to the society, who have contributed to the nation. This is something very, very important. I was speaking to you about discipline. Now, discipline consists in many things, doing many things. First of all, children, you need to be respectful and obedient to your parents. Some of you at times do not care to your parents. Sometimes you use even abusive language that is not permitted in the Luddite family. We really like to have obedient children who really respect and care for their parents, and always you have to be obedient. So listen to your parents very, very carefully in terms of what they serve you as food. Don't say, I don't like vegetables, and I don't like that dish and this dish. I only like to eat sandwiches or hamburgers. You cannot say that. Your parents will give you healthy food, both for the tiffin and for your breakfast and dinner. Respect that. Because children, the parents are having a very difficult time. Maybe some of them are getting a very fat salary, a big salary, but many of them have lost that fat salary. They are drawing 50%, 25%. And some of the people who are in business, they are not having any business. People are not getting contracts. Perhaps your parents have not shared with you the difficulties at home. Maybe your parents have borrowed loans so that they may pay the school fee. So become very much aware of the difficulties. Be very, very sensitive to what is happening in your families. This is something very, very important. Likewise, I'm very particular that you have a sense of the sacred or the devotion. Unless you learn to light a diya, devarige deepa hachudu, unless you learn to light a diya, unless you learn to make namaz, namaz madlike kaliyadiddare, Christian makkalu devarige prarthana madlike kaliyadiddare, adu jeevana devarige mattu pararige samarpisidantadu helalu sadhyavilla. It has to be a life dedicated to the mighty God. It has to be a life dedicated to the other. So, obediently, reverently praying to the mighty God for all the blessings that we need, and respecting our faculty members, parents, and our companions is a must in this school. Likewise, once again, return after 8 months to the normal habits of the school. Some of you still require a beautiful haircut, both boys and girls. I see that you need to be combing your hair properly, tying it in a proper manner. You need to really press your uniform. It should be really clean. It should be clean. Your bag should be clean. Also, parents take note of that, teachers take note of that, what they contain, what do they have in the bags, because it's very important from the COVID perspective, teachers, that you check the bags of your students and that they keep it very clean. And don't hesitate, teachers, to tell every student that they need to be clean in terms of their physical appearance. And likewise, you need to be very, very clean inside. I believe the principal of the school, the vice principal, and the faculty members really take care of the COVID norms and make sure that our students are well disciplined. Parents, I have a small request as you bring the students to the school. You know, those 10 minutes are very, very important. Imagine we have more than 2016 students, and every one of you are coming either in big cars, most of you are coming in the cars, some of you are coming by bus and others are by the scooters and the autos, but everybody is in a heavy rush. But all of us are having either one child or two children, maybe a few of you have three children. Every life is very, very precious. And for the last 8 months, 9 months, you are not used to the school campus. We request you to follow the driving rules, particularly the guidance given to you inside the campus, that you follow very, very meticulously, so that our job of protecting the children of others really becomes a soothing experience. It's not just your child. We are responsible for all the children of these 400 plus parents. And that's why, come 10 or 15 minutes early, drop your children in the right place and go back very, very slowly. I know that you have to go for work, but come a little bit early. Get up 15 minutes early and bring your children 15 minutes before the time, so that everything functions very smoothly. Wish you the very best. God bless you.
Expressing your thoughts and encouraging us to have a positive attitude towards the challenges that we have to face. Thank you, Father.
Gratitude is the fairest blossom which springs from the soul. On behalf of our LCS family, I would like to thank our manager, Reverend Dr. John Baptist Saldana, for the constant support and for addressing us today. We will definitely try our best to be disciplined. Thank you for joining us today. I extend my sincere thanks to our principal, Reverend Father Robert De Souza, for his motivation. Thank you, Father. I would also like to thank our Vice Principal, Mrs. Belita Mascarenhas, for her guidance. Thank you, Ma'am. Behind every successful program lies the hard work of our faculty members. A big thank you to all the teaching and non-teaching staff. I would like to thank all the parents and my fellow Luddites for actively participating in this program.
Celebrate endings for they precede new beginnings, says Jonathan Huey. So we are all ready and eager to begin regular school. As we formally come to the end of this welcome program, may the vision of our founder rekindle a new beginning in each of us. With this, I, Steve DiMello of Class 9C,
and I, Rizal De Silva of Class 9B,
would like to conclude today's assembly. Have a marvelous day ahead. Let us rise for the school anthem.
Thank you.